Choreb Beruach,
Sword of the Spirit. Interpreted and narrated by Wendy. BeRashit, Genesis, Chapter 19.
And the two angels came to Sedum in the evening, and Luth sat in the gate of Sedum. Then Luth saw them, and he arose to meet them, and he bowed his face towards the ground. Then he said, "My lords, behold now, turn towards the house of your servant, I pray you, and tarry all night, and wash your feet. Then you will rise up early and go on your way." But they said, "No, for we will abide in the street all night." However, he pressed upon them greatly. Therefore, they turned towards him and entered into his house. Then he made them a feast and baked unleavened bread. So they ate. But before they laid down, the mortals of the city, the mortals of Sedum, encompassed around the house, both young and old, all the people from every quarter. Then they called to Luth and asked of him, "Where are the mortals who came to you this night? Bring them out to us, that we may know them." So Luth went out at the door towards them, and the door was shut behind him. Then he said, "I pray you, brethren, do not so wickedly. Behold now, I have two daughters who have not known a man. I pray you, allow me to bring them out to you, and do to them as is good in your eyes. Only, do not speak to these mortals, for they came under the shadow of my roof." But they said, "Stand back." Then they said again, "Has this one come to sojourn? And will he be a judge? Now we will deal worse with you than with them." Then they pressed sorely upon the man, Luth, and they came near to break in the door. But the mortals put forth their hands and pulled Luth towards them into the house, and the door was shut. Then they struck the mortals who were at the door of the house with blindness, both great and small, so that they wearied themselves to find the door. And the mortals asked Luth, "Who else do you have here? Bring them out of this place, sons-in-law, and your sons, and your daughters, and whoever you have in the city. For we will destroy this place, because the cry of them has waxed great before the face of he who exists. And he who exists has sent us to destroy it." Therefore, Luth went out and spoke to his sons-in-law, who married his daughters, and said, "Get up, get out of this place, for he who exists will destroy this city." But he seemed like a mocker to his sons-in-law. And when the morning arose, then the angels hastened Luth, saying, "Arise, take your wife and your two daughters, who are here, lest you are consumed in the iniquity of the city." And while he lingered, the men laid hold upon his hand, and upon the hand of his wife, and upon the hand of his two daughters, by the mercy of Yahuwah towards him. Then they brought him forth, and set him outside the city. And it came to pass, when he brought them out abroad, then he said, "Escape for your life. Look not behind you, nor remain in the plain. Escape to the mountain, lest you are consumed." And Luth said to them, "Oh, not so, Adonai. Behold now, your servant has found grace in your sight, and you have magnified your mercy, which you have shown to me in saving my life. But I cannot escape to the mountain, lest some evil overtake me and I die. Behold now, there is a city near to flee to, and it is a little one. Oh, let me escape there. Is it not a little one? And my soul will live. Thus he replied to him, Behold, I have carried your presence. Also, concerning this word, I will not destroy the city of which you have spoken. Hasten yourself, escape there, for I am not able to do anything until you arrive there. Thus the name of the city was called Zoar, small. The sun was risen upon the earth when Luth entered into Zoar. Then Yehuah rained upon Sedum and Amorah, fire and brimstone, from Yehuah from out of the heavens. And he overthrew those cities, and all the plain, and all the inhabitants of the cities, and those who grew upon the Adama. However, his wife looked back from behind him, and she became a pillar of salt. Furthermore, Abraham got up early in the morning to the place where he stood before Yehuah, and he looked towards Sedum and Amorah, and towards all the land of the plain, and he saw and beheld the smoke of the country, going up like the smoke of a furnace. And it came to pass, when Elohim destroyed the cities of the plain, that Elohim remembered Abraham. Thus he sent Luth out of the midst of the overthrow, when he overthrew the cities in which Luth dwelt. Then Luth went up out of Zoar, and dwelt in the mountain, and his two daughters were with him, for he feared to dwell in Zoar. Thus he dwelt in a cave, he and his two daughters. Therefore the firstborn said to the younger, Our father is old, and there is not a man in the earth to come unto us after the manner of all the earth. Come, let us make our father drunk with wine, and we will lie with him, that we may preserve the seed of our father. Therefore they made their father drunk with wine that night. And the firstborn went in and laid with her father. However, he did not perceive when she laid down, nor when she arose. And it came to pass on the morrow that the firstborn said to the younger, Behold, last night I laid with my father. Let us make him drunk with wine this night also. Then you go in and lie with him, that we may preserve the seed of our father. Therefore they made their father drunk with wine that night also. And the younger arose and laid with him. But he did not perceive when she laid down, nor when she arose. Thus both of the daughters of Luth were with child by their father. And the firstborn bore a son, and called his name Moab, from his father. The same is the father of Moab to this day. And the younger also, she bore a son, and she called his name Ben-Ami, son of my people. The same is the father of the children of Ammon to this day.